All right, guys, so here we are at Halloween headquarters, and I'll show you. Hey, look, check it out. Some of the stuff is going, can you believe it? But it's not going to Tacoma, to the stadium, it's going elsewhere. We're doing a different event, but yeah, no problems with Troy at all. I love Troy and Keith. We didn't have the right materials to do the kind of event that they kind of wanted to do out there. And I can't do it all by myself. So, you know, I just came to the realization that, and then with, you know, Troy's got a new baby coming up too, and he has a job and a lot of things going on. So the kind of a level event that those guys want to do, which is cool. It's just for me, I don't have that kind of budget to make it happen. And Troy didn't either, so. You know, unfortunately, that happens when you're trying to put together a haunt. Everybody has to come together just like stars in the sky. You know, it all has to mesh. And if it doesn't work out in plan or whatever, initially, and you don't get the right vibe, then you have to make sure that you're doing it right, because you throw a lot of money and time into this. And that's why I make up a plan like I did, so you all get a good idea of what I need to do in order to make this fly as far as a certain event goes. And in this particular situation, everywhere we were searching, where's the budget? And we, you know, got a goose egg. And so it was hard to draw up a specific plan as to what the event was gonna be and then make the event. So what I was trying to do is take the pieces of the puzzle that I had and then put them into the event. So that way we had enough to fill the event and we had a reason for it all being there. And so that it just didn't conjive with the other idea of creating the event from, you know, the story and stuff. So yeah, it's nothing personal, nothing like that at all, guys. So it's just business. And for me, I got to make sure I make money. That's number one. And then all the other stuff comes second. So getting open with the right folks, with the right, you know, intentions as far as haunts go is first and foremost. And I'm a little bit rough around the edges, I'll tell anybody that. But, you know, I'm not afraid to use chainsaws and stuff at my haunts. And I like blades and I like metal. And I like rock and roll and death metal and that kind of stuff for my haunted houses. And some people don't like that. Not saying in Troy, he likes everything. But I'm just saying, so I'm a little bit more hardcore than some people and not as hardcore as some other people. But it's all what you like in haunted houses. That's where you got to start. Number one, where you got to start. Every haunter that you know, and probably you right there, have a passion for haunted houses, number one. And for anybody else to work with somebody else as far as like vision goes, you have to have the right passion for that vision, because everybody has their specific likes and dislikes as far as the vision of the event goes. To me, I don't really care so much as I care about getting the event together and organized and really scary situations going on. And I get that kind of organized with a base plan as far as, okay, we're going to have this haunt here and we're going to have that haunt there, because it's what we have, we're going to have that haunt here. And we've made those haunts up out of things that we actually have already. And then we go, okay, well, these things make sense in what fashion? And we say, okay, well, they make sense in this fashion. And so from there, we try to develop a kind of a guideline of what it's all about. That's how I work, because I don't have generally each year, I do it all on my own. I don't have a big giant budget to build a lot of stuff every single year. So every year I have to kind of use the same stuff I have. And so, yeah, that's just kind of the way I have to run my haunts. But, you know, for Troy, it's awesome because he can start out fresh and new and build all the stuff from scratch and make it just the way it has to be that tie in with that story that he likes so much. It's, you know, that's what it has to be. And for me, I just couldn't afford it. And so I'm sorry, man, it didn't work out. But hey, guys, don't worry, because I'm still haunting the earth as always. As you can see, we dropped off, this is a different load, but we dropped off a couple loads of a different trailer. So I got a lot soaking wet. I should have took you on that journey. And yeah, it's going to be a rocking year. That's all I can say. And stay tuned to the Hauntguy, because we're always doing something crazy. and we'll show you the setup and what we're doing here pretty soon. So you guys stay tuned. And Troy, good luck to you guys out there. And I love the idea of Hellmouth Hot Sauce. You have a great marketing person there. Let them be your number one main idea for your whole company. Seriously. Brilliant person. Awesome idea. Good job. See ya. All right, guys. So here we are. It's another wonderful day in Oregon. And we got Jack here. Hey, Jack. Say hi to him.
Peace, brothers.
Jack's the tree man today. As you can see, it's tree day. We're going through some of these Christmas trees that we had for the cemetery and organizing them and wrapping them up for the road trip. And there's a lot of them. We got trees everywhere. And we don't put the run the Christmas lights on them, so to speak. We just kind of dress them up scary like.
Some of them have them built into it, but you deal with it.
You deal with it, yeah. And then we're also doing this mess. So first off, I got to show you this, Troy. Can you see that? That's a pneumatic cylinder there for your car. And it'll push it out approximately 2 feet, give or take. But yeah, there it is. That's brand new. It's a little rusty because it's been sitting around, but it's still good. That thing's expensive. But that's for your car, for the prop car. And if that one doesn't work, maybe we can make this one work as well. We'll make it do two different functions rather than just one backup function. Maybe it can lift a lid or something. I don't know. But I got two big cylinders for the prop car. And then we're going through this mess, which is just more stuff. And you can see all the way back up in there, it's just loaded to the gills with crap. And it's really condensed in there. But yeah, we're organizing today more to get prepared because the time is coming.
And the time is here.
The time is now. Yeah, so things have been moving right along on this end. I hope everything's going well on the Hellmouth end over there. It's all about BAM! In your face, you know it's going to be freaking scary. That's what it's about, man. It's what we're about this year. Total in your face, raw fear. That's what I'm going for. Scary. Really scary. Yeah, and so we're also digging out the costumes here. And so we got some funky old clown costumes that I'll probably make into static props for outside or something. Yeah, you know, you gotta have at least one clown. The guy that got kicked out of the whole clown clan a long time ago, he's just pissed off and hanging around the haunt because they got rid of clowns. And he's mad as hell about it.
So. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now, there's just a bunch of funky costumes, and I got a whole shitload. Where are they? Right here. These space suits. These are the shoes for them, but the whole suits are like this because we got a whole crap load of those things. They're full body suits, and they're booties. Terrible, terrible, terrible. But it's coming together, believe it or not, soon. It will be a haunt. All right, having too much fun here. And Jack, how's the sorting going?
Getting done. Yes, we are.
So yeah, he's sorting, and I'm sorting, and everything's getting a little more organized. So, because some of this stuff when we came in the last minute was pouring down rain, so we just kind of pushed it in there, especially these trees. So we're trying to get them all wrapped up so they're organized. Tomorrow we're gonna have a little bit of a yard sale. Get rid of more stuff because we can't possibly bring it all down there. I got enough for probably altogether probably 6 haunted houses, guys. So if you want to put up a haunted house, I got more crap. I need more places for it to go. So let me know. And just so you guys get an indication, Psycho Stadium's a pretty big deal, but it's actually the smallest haunted house we've ran since I opened back in 2003. And that's simply because the haunt attractions themselves can't be quite as big because of the area we're working with. But the actual park itself is fairly large. But so a lot of this gear is still going to need a home. If you want to open a pro haunt, or you just want to buy some wall panels and stuff, just hit me up, man. I'm making deals for Halloween. All right, so in here, you can probably see right up in here the column towers for the castle. These are the spires that will be out in front of the castle, and there will be a couple other ones that are kind of buried in here. But that's what's kind of going to be on the front of the castle. So we'll be bringing those out probably second round, we're thinking. And the good thing is we don't have a lot of building to do on site. We just have setting up to do on site, which is basic easiness. And really the tough part comes on Troy. He's got to do the detailing. And that can be, as you guys know, quite strenuous, but the walls will be there. Yeah, the walls will be there. The props will be there. The trees will be there. The air pneumatics will be there. The lights will be there. The audio will be there. The safety gear. Jack might even be there.
I just might. Y'all want me there? I'll be there.
He might be there. We got Ram Man coming out to help us on the
Ram Man.
Ram Man's coming out to help us. And I saw on his Hellmouth, one of his latest vlogs, where Keith, seems like you got your ass kicked there.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, by an old man nonetheless.
What?
But you know what? I didn't realize until I saw that video that Ram is like the size of one of these giant wrestlers from hell. He's a big guy, man. And awesome. Those are the kind of guys you want on the haunt team right there. Big badasses. Good job, Ram.
Hi, guys. It's Jack. I'm pulling off something I know I shouldn't be doing, because it is kind of important, but it's all right. You know, I'm pulling off a doctor's appointment today. Physical therapy and then blood work.
Well, so far he's gotten both. He's doing physical therapy right here, and he's poked himself 3 times, so the blood work is done.
Pretty much, you know, in a sense, you know, if the nurses were here, they would have got it all.
And so, yeah, we got street signs, too, so if you want to add some street signs, just let me know to the plan there. Maybe we can put some street signs up as you're walking through the stairs. Yep, yeah, buddy.
We have lots of them.
Hey, so Diablo, Mr. Prop Dude, I finally broke it out right here, the big giant pumpkin head. And so I'm going to lay it down like Ghost Town, and I am making a badass prop for Psycho Stadium. That's the start of it right there. It's going to be a giant rising grave pumpkin. He's going to go way the fuck up here. Big.
15.
Big.
10, 15 feet, man.
Yeah, so you guys...
Bigger, maybe.
I haven't had a chance to do my pneumatic magic for a long time, so we're going to do a little bit of that before we go. Some cool pneumatic magic. We're really good at making pneumatic props, and so I want to show you making a giant prop. And this guy won't look so happy when we're done with him, either. No, I'm not talking about Jack. I'm talking about the pumpkin.
Oh.
All right, so we came to the conclusion that there's no possible way we're ever going to figure out how all these trees go together. So we're just going to bundle them up and, well, hopefully Troy can figure it out. That's all I got to say. No, actually we did. We figured out most of the trees. So what the hell are you doing over there?
I am the god of hellfire, and I bring you hell! Oh, I forgot something. My safety helmet.
Oh, yes, you're...
I'm still working.
You know, kind of one of those things.
Wow, you look like Steven Tyler, kind of with red hair. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, just add in music to that and it'll be awesome. Yeah, some dancing.
Big! Big!